intelligent, just still grow it back to my soul until it decides. Whenever the smoke clear out of my face and my picture buried in the yellow cry, all of that green and yellow that drip your eyes is telling, tell your demise. I'm with to my side to push register and put better feelings. I had to decide, we made them nice and wipe on my side. All I see is the sea of people that follow me. If they just knew what's got it with you, to trip out this page and say I'm a child, busy, creative, and animals waited. I gotta find balance and keep me a smile. Yeah, yeah. That shit wild, instead of my ear, I took it for zero. The flame you say, I'm ready for miles. The shit was in love, they got me fucked up. I put your own bus and took you around. A couple of guys, silent school, I came to choose and get it up crying. They say they're the ones when they make their ears, can't look in the mirror. That shit wild, instead on the stage, I came to rage. I'm turning it down, continue to keep power. We're doing the streets, we do it for keys, we do it for rides. I'm making too easy, shit ain't for pleasure. I'm coming to dreams, this shit is for me. If it ain't up in A, you invited, I'm wrapping around. I'll take me a pin, I turned to a piece. About the grip on it, I made it harder to reach. But a couple more words, cause I need it once. But a couple more watches, I need it more time. They invited, I know it was part of the lease. And I'm also more ice, cause I bought it. They made a cast of my niche, so you make me go cheat. If I get you a day in my life, one day in my eyes, don't leave.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Sam Odeyemi. Welcome to another edition of Point to the Paint, brought to you by For Frequency's Sake Podcast Network. Hello. We talk all things here, NBA, NBA basketball. We are currently in the midst of the NBA playoffs. We've been kind of going week to week, kind of just looking over the series. Since our last show, last Monday, a few teams have been sent home. And now we're on pretty much to the second round. I believe Orlando and Cleveland was the last first round matchup yesterday. So as it currently stands, Mavericks and Thunder game one kicks off tomorrow. Minnesota and Denver game two kicks off tonight. And I'll touch on game one in a bit. Boston and Cleveland game one is tomorrow. And the Knicks and the Pacers are currently playing right now. That's game one. The Timberwolves and the Nuggets played over the weekend. I was able to catch that game. That was a really good game. I'm surprised Minnesota won. Minnesota's definitely they're playing some really good basketball right now. I do legitimately think Denver might be in trouble. They might just have some championship hangover. They won a championship last year. Obviously takes a lot, plays a lot of games. So the repeat is champions. You have to play 32 extra. You have to win 32 extra games and just the playoffs alone. So that can weigh on the team. That's down there almost a season, extra half of a season. If you count if you're going to take some losses along those ways, lose a game here and there. So you're probably playing close to 30 some extra games. So that can wear on the team. The Timberwolves just looked more energized, but Timberwolves bench definitely showed out. Naz Reid played well. Kyle Anderson, those other guys, they played well. But really, Anthony Edwards is just special. Some of those plays he had late in the game in the fourth quarter, he was able to help, Minnesota, keep that lead and, just that turnaround he had. I think on KCP, he backed down Reggie Jackson when he got a foul. And when he had that breakaway layup, he's just the best player on the floor. He's just playing at a different gear. No matter who Denver's thrown at him, Jokic has covered him on switches, and that just – he can just drive past Jokic. Michael Porter Jr., he's driven past, so he's gotten fadeaway. Aaron Gordon, KCP, Reggie Jackson, Jamal Murray, all these goons have guarded him. Have had their turn guarding Anthony Edwards, and yet it just doesn't matter. So if he can continue to play at this level, and then obviously Gobert and Towns and the other guys continue to show up, Minnesota just looks like they're the team playing with more to lose, more to win. So I could totally see Minnesota winning this series, 3-2 matchup. So it wouldn't be surprising. And then we have Dallas and OKC in the second round. Those two teams kick off tomorrow. I'm going to give a slight early nudge to Dallas. I think Dallas has more size inside with Derek Lively and Daniel Gafford. Oklahoma City just has Chet. I mean, Shays is special, but so is Luka and Kyrie. So out of those three, they're all going to put up numbers, but I think Dallas just has more experience. Thing that sucks for Dallas is Max Kleber is out for the series, and he's a big piece part of what they do. So Dallas bench needs to consistently show up. And that means Dante Exum and Tim Hardaway Jr. He's got to make shots. And the other guys got to show up and play well. P.J. Washington's got to play well. Derek Jones Jr. got to play well, you know, for Dallas to win this series, especially on the road, because that OKC crowd is nuts. So I think that'll be a good series. I'm kind of giving a slight nod to Dallas just because of Luka and Kyrie tandem. I like how they're playing off each other. Luka kind of gets started early. You know, he can score and facilitate as needed. But then Kyrie's in the fourth quarter, Kyrie's your closer. He's your guy getting to the buckets. He's hitting those tough shots. And I like how they feed off of each other. So I think Dallas is kind of finding their groove at the right time. And I think Dallas is the better team in that series. So we'll see. That game one of that is tomorrow. All right. Okay, game one of the Celtics and Cavaliers. That's also tomorrow as well. I'm going to give a nod to the Celtics that series. I think Darius Garland and even Donovan Mitchell will have their moments. I think Donovan Mitchell will definitely have his moments, but I just think Boston's experience, especially in the front court, I think it might be too much for Cleveland. But we'll see. But I'm giving the edge to Boston. I think Boston comes out with a lot of energy. Jaylen Brown, Jason Tatum, those guys are just playing really good. Drew Holiday, the point of attack. I guess I didn't even think they could put Drew Holiday on Donovan Mitchell. That's going to be tough. So, yeah, I'm giving the edge to Boston in the series. Porzingis is out with a calf injury, lower leg injury. I don't know the specific injury, lower leg. But I still want to give the edge to Boston. Cleveland just played a game 7 versus Orlando yesterday, but they have a day off of rest in between. Boston's, play Miami, and they beat Miami last week. So Boston's had time to rest and recover and more time for Porzingis. I think Al Horford, they've been here, done that. And I think Boston is just playing better basketball right now. So I'm giving the edge to them. I mean, like I said, Cleveland just played a 7-game series versus Orlando where they played Banchero and Wagner, two nice young forwards, but two nice inexperienced young forwards. Boston's different. Jaylen Brown, Jason Tatum, they're both six-year veterans. They've both been in the NBA for some time, and so that's a whole different ball game that Cleveland's got to contend with. Cleveland's got some perimeter players, Mobley and Okoro, Strus, that they could Tristan Thompson, they could potentially try to throw at these guys, but I think Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum are going to win most of the matchups on the perimeter in that series. So yeah, that game again kicks off tomorrow as well. And then now we have the Knicks and the Pacers, 27 all. I'm hoping I can probably catch some of the series afterwards. But this series is going to be interesting. I want to pick the Knicks, but I think it's whoever is able to impose their will more. So if the Pacers are able to get up and down and it's a high-scoring game, the Pacers will win this series. But if the Knicks are able to control the pace and grind it out, I think New York's got the edge. Right now it's currently tied 27 all. But Knicks do have home court advantage in this series. I'll just say that. Injuries, I don't know of any injuries besides the ones we already know about. I think too, what I heard another analyst say is Tom Thibodeau's gonna go 8 deep, so it's important for, New York not to get into a running contest with those with the Pacers. And I'm looking at the roster now, and I think he's played nine guys already, maybe even 10. So if that's the case, then Tibbs is learning. Because, yeah, Indiana's good. Tyrese Halliburton. He's special, and Miles Turner's nice, and they have good pieces. And they beat Milwaukee in the first round. I don't know if they are ready to take that next leap, and win another round. But Knicks lost in the second round last year to Miami. Tough series. I know Jalen Brunson played bad, especially in the late games. He had a couple turnovers in that Miami series. I remember one game he turned the ball over in crucial moments. So I know they want to get that off their chest. Josh Hart, Dante DiVincenzo, those three guys, obviously they all played together at college. So That's kind of been, you know, their battle cry. And then they have obviously OG Anunoby, Hartenstein, Achiuwa, Mitchell Robinson, Miles McBride. So they have a legit eight guys. I mean, he's got some veterans. Losing Bogdanovich was sucks for the Knicks because he's a scorer. But I think they can still get enough from other guys. Like, I'm looking at the box score now. Josh Hart has 9. Jalen Brunson has 10. OG's got 3. And Hartenstein's got 4. Nothing from DiVincenzo yet. So he'll have to pick it up. And then they can get stuff off their bench, more from their bench. They only have 1 bench point from Achiuwa. But I think New York's in good position to win this series. I think New York is in a good position to make the Eastern Conference Finals. And I don't think I've ever seen maybe that one year when the Knicks played the Miami Heat in the playoffs. I don't know if that was an Eastern Conference Finals, but they played Miami. It might have been the semis, but I don't think I've ever seen the Knicks make the Eastern Conference Finals. No, not. Yeah, I think it's always been second round. I don't think they got past second round. So this is their chance right now, playing a young, inexperienced team in Indiana. So that'd be a nice series to follow. Like I said, I'll give the early nod in that series to the Knicks. It's kind of nice. See Obi Toppin get to play against his old team in the playoffs. Revenge series. You know, that's always nice to note. I'm sure there's some other things I can draw from it. OG Anunoby and Pascal Siakam were former teammates. Now they've been serious for Toronto. Now they're both on separate teams. Looking at the Indiana box score, Haliburton's got 3, Nembhard's 3, Nesmith 4, Toppin 3, 4, 6 for McConnell, 4 for Isaiah Jackson, 6 for Shepherd. Yeah, Indiana's definitely getting that balanced scoring going. I think Haliburton's got an injury or something, or he rushed back from the injury, so he hasn't been putting up the same numbers. So if other guys are going to be scoring, that's good for him. Indiana's already gone 9 deep. New York's gone 8 deep. So yeah, we'll see. All right, and also Victor Wembanyama won Rookie of the Year. If anybody's surprised. that's really, really all the other news. I think the lottery's getting ready to start. NBA draft lottery starts May 12th. And there's that free agency buzz about who's going to sign who. And some coaches got re-signed to extensions. Jason Kidd got an extension. Congrats, Jason Kidd. Yeah. But besides that, in the playoffs, nothing really going on. So just kind of been taking in these playoff series. It's been, you know, great. Changing of the guard. No LeBron, no Curry, no Durant in the second round. But you got your Anthony Edwards, Jamal Murray, Jalen Brunson, Luka Doncic, you know, Kyrie Irving. You got your special Jason Tatum, Jaylen Brown. We got your special players in that class. So it's just good. It's just fun to be appreciative of that, this talent, especially at this level and at this stage. Let's see. Do I have anything else? No, I think that's it. All right, guys. Another edition. Thank you for joining me for another edition of Points in the Paint. As always, my Twitter handle is below at Mark0220. I should have mentioned that earlier, but tweet me if anything you want to talk to me, anything basketball. Is there anything you want me to touch on? Shoot me a tweet or whatnot. I'd love to hear from you. I will be back next week. Of course, we've kind of just been going every week with the NBA playoffs going. And now that we're in the second round, I'm pretty sure we're winding down here. So, yeah, we'll just keep this gravy train going. Yeah, and if I do go next week, I could talk about the NBA draft lottery, because I want to see where the Bulls end up, if they keep their first round pick or not. So yeah, again, thank you for joining me. Another edition of Points in the Paint, brought to you by Four Frequencies Sake. You have a wonderful evening. 33-32 Pacers. 8 minutes and 5 seconds in the second quarter. Rudy Gobert is questionable for game two tonight for Denver. Denver, Minnesota. That's all I got.